So tell me a little more about your Architects of Peace project, some of which is displayed here at the AMU Library. What was the inspiration for that?
Well, it actually comes back to Mother Teresa, because in 1982 I met Mother and then had photographed her up until her passing, which was 1997. And after that, I was thinking about what I would do later. And we ended up doing a book. Mother gave us permission to actually do a book and fully participated. About a year prior to her passing, the book came out and she got a chance to see it. And then I told Mother that I had this interest in documenting peacemakers around the world, and I thought that that would be the work that I'd want to pursue further. And she said, just be inclusive, not be exclusive in regard to the people that you document. So I always kind of kept that in mind. And at that time, since Mother had won a Nobel Peace Laureate, she was a Nobel Peace Laureate, I thought that maybe I'd start with the Nobel Peace Prize winners and document as many of those individuals that I could get to. And so shortly after, I started getting to know people like the Dalai Lama and a real diverse kind of interest in people of different ethnicities and faiths and working around the world to change life for the better in their own community or in their own state or country. And I also became very interested in human rights activists and civil rights activists. So I started documenting some of the civil rights heroes in the United States, many of which are not with us anymore, and spiritual leaders. I ended up following Pope John Paul II on a couple of trips to Mexico and certainly out at the Vatican as well, and social entrepreneurs, individuals who were changing the world from their perspective of their particular vocation, their work vocation. Maybe it's an invention that they came up with to change the lives of so many of the poor people in the developing world. So it really was a project that went way beyond my initial kind of thinking of it. And now I've come to have photographed 37 Nobel Peace Laureates, which would reflect probably about 28 or 30 years of the Nobel Peace Prize being given out, and a host of individuals, hundreds of social entrepreneurs and human rights activists, and just community activists, people who I come across, or individuals that point to, who I may have photographed, said, hey, have you thought about this individual to document as well? And it really takes on a life of its own, and I love being able to meet somebody new who's changing the world, and how wonderful to be able to go around and photograph and meet all your heroes. Mm-hmm. So it's been an extraordinary journey of meeting people like Nelson Mandela, and I've known the Dalai Lama for 35 years, and he's got a remarkable sense of humor. So it's always fun to be around people like that. And in fact, when I think about the thread of so many different people and what links them together, I would say humility is one big theme, and also a sense of humor. So I appreciate that.
Definitely.
And I always thought, Annie, that this would be a good project for individuals in the school system. So oftentimes I like to have this exhibit out in front of classrooms, so that students can kind of think about who these people are, maybe be inspired by their life examples or reading, you know, a particular quote, and thinking about how they may integrate their lives into their own life vocation or life path. That's what really happened to me. And I oftentimes think that, you know, in schools where we have a lot of the exhibits, it helps students with their own vocational discernment and their own vocational path, because perhaps they came into school not really knowing what they wanted to do, and coming across an individual who may have started their own nonprofit serving the poor or serving a particular need in the community might have been something that they hadn't thought of, but maybe it lights them up or inspires them in some way. And the other thing, honestly, is really to prolong the lives of these individuals, many of which who are left have gone and passed away. And, you know, many people don't know who Nelson Mandela, Mother Teresa, Billy Graham, looking around the exhibit, who these individuals are. So I think it's very important as an educational tool to see where we came from, maybe be challenged by a particular person who doesn't think like we do, maybe is a different faith, different kind of mindset, but is also using that, their platform or their vocation in life, to change other lives for the better. And I think that that's very important too, to be challenged and to be inspired on that level as well, and realize that that's really the purpose of our lives, and really the way of happiness. You know, the path to happiness is really in service to other people.